everyone, you're now watching the live stream of CGTN. As you can see, I'm holding a very exquisite umbrella, and this umbrella is called oil paper umbrella, in Chinese, 油纸伞. And this umbrella is made by the same technique that is can date back hundreds of years ago. You can see the interior of this umbrella, it's very delicate. And all the procedure and every part of this umbrella is handmade. You might be curious why this ancient umbrella can be made in modern days. Actually, I am standing in a county called Fenshuiling, and this is located in southwest China's Sichuan province, Luzhou City. And this part, this place is actually the orientation of the oil paper umbrella. And here, there is a family of bee family. They have been made umbrella since Qing Dynasty. It has hundreds of years of history, and because of they still using the same technique that their ancestors are passing down to them, the technique of making this oil paper umbrella have nominated and appointed as a national intangible cultural heritage. And where I'm standing is actually a tourist attraction, and here because of the oil paper umbrella is also a name card of Luzhou City. So here there is umbrella museum, just to show the tourist how the oil paper umbrella is made. And maybe you are wondering why lots of the craftsmen or artisans making old ancient umbrellas, they are often old age or basically, they must have gray hairs. But I happen to know someone that he is also from the bee family, and he's the seventh generation of the inheritor. So let's talk to him. Bee 老师, 您好. Now he's bee 原身, the seventh generation of this bee family making oil paper umbrellas. So let's introduce yourself to us.
我是油纸伞传统制作技艺第七代传承人，我叫毕元生，欢迎你们。好，李氏从什么时候开始学油纸伞？我是从小就跟着我的父亲、跟着我的爷爷奶奶在做，但是呢，我正式的开始做是从我大学毕业以后，因为当时我们这个油纸伞传统制作技艺被评为了国家级非物质文化遗产以后，因为当时面临着很多困难，后继发人啊这些很多困难，然后我父亲就叫我回来传承这一门手艺。
Yes, before I talked to Mr. B, that he told me he was majoring in computer science, and after graduation and work in Chengdu for many years, and he decided to come back to inherit this craft. So, 可以介绍一下这个油纸伞的历史给我们吗？ Want to introduce the history of the oil paper umbrella?
我们从这边开始吗？好。你看，像这么小的伞，是我们最近开始做的，就是一些小的油纸伞。 这个可能还有比这小的，就像手巴掌那么大的。
Those small umbrellas are a new trend, and also they have some smaller umbrellas that is the size of the palm.
可以介绍一下这个具体的这些步骤吗？好的。
Introduce the specific procedure of making an umbrella.
这个油纸伞也是我们比较具有的这个特色的。这个油纸伞是我们在 做纸的时候，把这个树叶和纸浆融在一块儿，然后这个树叶，这天然的植物，它是镶嵌在这个纸的里面，这个叫做我们叫做植物标本的油纸伞，它这种的话，我们开发了有很多，像这种是艾叶草的，我们有四叶草，还有枫叶，有竹叶，这种元素也是比较流行的一个款式。
So there are real plants inside the umbrella while making the paper, while applying the paper on the umbrella. They have made those actual plants inside it. It's also a popular trend nowadays.
我们的油纸伞呢，它是全手工制作的，就是从选料到最后做完的话，如果说一个人来做的话，需要七天的时间，它的总共的工序有100多道工序。
He told me that if making umbrella needs a one man to work 7 days if he is making it alone, and almost 100 procedures to make it.
你们现在还是用这100多道工序在做上。对，我们一直都是坚持这个全手工制作。像这个伞的图案，我们叫做百鸟朝凤，也是我们比较传统的一个图案。回头我会给你介绍，这个图案它是通过石板印刷制作成的。这种图案有这个百鸟朝凤的，还有这个叫做双凤朝阳，这个叫百鸟朝凤，还有那个龙凤呈祥。
So they are, the patterns are printed by a stone board. It's still the ancient way. And the bee family here is still using the techniques that can date back thousands of years ago. And they are stick to the almost 100 procedures to make the umbrellas.
这个是我们的一个做伞的一个工序的，就是说做伞面的一个工序。 因为我们的伞的话，别人看着一个圆，它有可能是认为是用一张完整的一个纸张把它做上去的。其实我们是通过很多个不同的扇形面这样做上去的。这样做上去的好处是因为可以截出，让这个纸张和这个伞骨增加它的接触面，然后能够更加的让伞经久耐用。It's
while applying the paper on the umbrella, The bee family in Luzhou are using the technique that divided the paper first and applying each square to it, so that it can be more sticker and more suitable for the umbrella.
那跟着过来一个全手工的一个伞面都是通过我们手工这样绘画绘上去的。
This umbrella, this surface of the umbrella is painted by hand. 这个油纸伞一般都是在什么场景下会送的比较多呢？这个的话，一般就是说，送的一些送朋友啊，就因为这个荷花嘛，在我们就是说出淤泥而不染，它代表了一些。
青年呢，就是更这种比较高尚的一些品德的这样的一些传统的元素。Those
new trend umbrellas are very popular among the young people, and this special picture resembles the good spirit of the young people. And this one is the traditional one. That one is the most trendy one.
你看，像我们走到这里的话，我们有一个。 巨型的油纸伞，这个是我们那个16年的时候，当时我的父亲宾六福先生他做的一把，直径有16.2米的一把巨型油纸伞，我们也成功的申报了那个吉尼斯世界纪录的。这个图案叫做天上丽江，是我们中国的那个一个桂林山水，把桂林山水的那些图案做到伞面上。
Also, they made the biggest umbrella in the world, the biggest oil paper umbrella in the world, and it won the Guinness Prize.
这个是成龙先生，他当时那个在19年的时候，我们一个亚洲闻名大会，当时他们有上千个就是功夫小孩嘛，他们专门就是我们专门给他们定做了一批油纸，红色的油纸伞。这批油纸伞，因为它是他们从小这些小孩是学功夫的，然后他们相当于他用的伞和我们平时的不一样。我们专门定做，专门去选材料，因为他要比我们通常的还要经久耐用，因为他们要像武术一样去挥来挥去的，所以说专门定制了一批，这个也是比较有代表性的一个。
Those umbrellas are also involved in Jackie Chan's program and to participate in a kung fu performance. And 这里写着染红伞，就是那种比较古老的技艺染的红色嘛。对，像这种红色的话，因为我们油纸伞的话，它
有很多寓意，它比如说它的形状是圆形，就是代表了我们一个中国的一个团圆、美满、幸福。还有这个油纸伞在传统婚礼上也是一种比较喜庆的一种 一种会用到的，就是说应当说在传统节日上面都会用到一些红色的元素。像我们最开始的红色的话，我们是通过一些猪血啊，就是这些能够起到一些辟邪啊这些作用在里面。然后现在我们有些没有这么做，但是有些人家特地要那种最传统的，我们就会用到就是猪血这样的一些元素在里面。
Yeah, some of the ancient painter of a red umbrella are made by the pig's blood. Let's see some umbrella making tools here.
你看，这里有很多我们的工具，这些工具的年龄的话都比我都还要大，有些是上百年的一些工具，这只是其中的一部分，一小部分。
Some of the tools are more than 100 years old. 这是都是家里传下来的吗？
对，还有很多，因为地方只有那么大，有些就放不上去。
Inherited from his family.
一会儿我还给你们带一点老的油纸伞给你们看，就是说有上百年的一些油纸伞。
Oh, these are the plant.
竹叶嘛，就是竹叶的，看上去也比较好看。嗯。它可惜，因为我们油纸伞以前是作为食用，现在可以作为一些装饰啊，一些个装饰品，这样其实也很好看的。
这个黄色是它本来的颜色吗？
黄色是我们之前用了一点点黄色，但是它随着时间的随着时间的推移，它会氧化一部分，它又会变得更黄一点。嗯。之前是有一点黄的。
这有年代的感觉。This umbrella is mostly the origin color of the umbrella, the oil paper umbrella.
这个地方是一些比较老的。这个伞我现在不能打开，因为锁起来了。它这个老的油纸伞，它其实有一个很重要的一个特点，它就是说里面的线，一会儿我们会看到里面有像这样子的里面穿的线。它以前的油纸伞的话，它都是用头发来做的，因为线它比较稀有嘛，当时因为那个物质比较匮乏的时候，很多都是用头发丝把这个伞作为一个连接的作用，把它连接在一块儿。
就这个伞里面就是头发丝连接的吗？
对，用头发丝。
哇。He told me that, as you can see the thread here in the modern umbrella, it's very delicate. But in ancient time, the thread is not very easy to find. So people use human's hair to connect the bamboos of the umbrella. And those umbrellas are some umbrella descendant in his family from, here says, 1840s. So Mr. B told me those umbrellas are actually linked by human hairs. This place is.
This place is our one.工艺的一个展示厅，它也有一些工具啊，还有平时我们在做直播的时候，我们也会在这个地方。
This place can demonstrate the hand making techniques, the crafts procedure of an oil umbrella. Also, he told me that sometimes they will have some live streaming here to demonstrate the making procedure and also attract some.
而且这里还有一个重要的，这个就是我们的石板印刷，放地上的。
Okay.
这个是我们独有的一个工序，全国都看不到，因为以前还是比较多，因为现在都没有了，叫做石板印刷。
This is special, stone board printing technique. 这个石板大概多大年纪了？
这个石板。
新的。
怎么说呢？这个石板的话，肯定它时间是很久很久用。我们用它可能都只是这么石板没用而已，它肯定是有几百年的时间了。像我们用的比较多的话，这个石板是凹进去的，因为我给你介绍一下这个工序的话，你就明白那个了。 像这上面有一个龙凤的一个龙头的一个图案，它就是我们之前那个红色的那个伞。我要不要把那个红色那个伞给拿过来？它就是一个龙的图案。龙的图案的话，因为我们那个红色的那个龙凤呈祥，它是有四种颜色。这是第一种颜色，这个是红色的一个描出来的。然后每一个颜色我们要制一次版，然后这只龙头的部分，它是分为了有七块或者是八块，因为伞的大小不一样，相当于我们如果是八块的话，我们就要制版就要制32次版，都是在这一款石板上面做。
每一次就是描成一个颜色，就可以印好几张伞。
印上千张，或者是几千张这样子印。因为如果说我们就印个一两张可以去制，因为制一次板是很麻烦的。然后如果这个板我们做完了不要了，我们就用那种磨刀石把这个板给磨掉。因为这个有一个特点，它因为和我们中国另外一种传统工艺那个年画，它是年画制板，它不一样。年画制板它是通过雕刻制板，它是凹。是凸出来的嘛，相当于是我们这个板是水平的，我们是利用这个油墨，它属于油水不相容的，然后那个墨里面我们在制板的时候是用独特的配方，用了一些生活中的酱油啊醋啊这些，就我们作为因为是我们自己研发的一个配方嘛，然后它能够腐蚀到这个石板上面，相当于这个你能够看到这个红色的地方它是被腐蚀过的，然后腐蚀的作用是为了下一次我们油墨去上油墨的时候，这个腐蚀过的地方那个油墨就会粘上去，然后我们但是在上油墨之前，我们先会用湿的那个布条去擦一下，然后让整个石板它是有水分，水分的话就利用油水不相容，只有那个上墨的时候就只有这个腐蚀过的地方它才会那个着上颜色，这样子我们就可以把它印出来。
He's introducing a very special ancient technique that can print things here. They're using a special mixture of oil and water. And after apply on this board, only the oil part can stay on this board, like the dragon here. And after applying the special mixture and then put a paper on it, and only the oil part will stay on the paper.
用了一个胶，叫做硫胶，就是不知道你们懂不懂一种相当于能够保护石板的一个作用。它这个上面是粘不上去的，它有一个保护石板的那个保护这个图案的作用在里面。像这个也是我们的一个庭院的，就是一个比如家里面有一个小的院子，可以放一把这样的油纸伞，还是挺有那个趣味的。
This huge umbrella can be placed in the yard, and it's also a kind of trend nowadays.
这些也是我们的一些会用到的工具嘛，各种像木料的锯子啊什么的，
Those tools are all using to cut the bamboo and the wood. But how to select the bamboo here to make the umbrella? How?这个就是怎样选择做油纸伞的竹子呢？
首先说我们选料的话会选取，因为我们当地都是就地取料嘛，我们会选取我们当地的3年以上的，然后是向阳面生长的，因为生长的老竹子，因为这样的话选的竹子它才会更加的在这个经久耐用的，就是说它比较结实一点。这样选的，因为太嫩的话，那个通过太阳晒，因为雨伞会撑出去，也太阳一晒的话，它就会出现变形啊什么的，所以说必须要选3年以上的，而且是向阳面生长的这个竹子。
向阳面为什么？
因为向阳面的话，它接受的阳光比较多，它长得就会比较老一点。如果同样是3年的话，它如果是背山面，因为山的另外一边的话，如果刚好是。它不是当西晒的另外一面的话，它就接受的阳光比较少的话，它可能就长出来就没有那么老，就相当于就是没有老，是用这个老这个词来形容。
那这种的小竹子是？
这种竹子它不一样，这种是 做伞把的，一会儿我们到那个毕老师那里，他会做，他会做这个给你们看。
嗯，所以这个伞把和这个骨
它的竹子
骨架是不一样的，
原料它材料是不一样的，一个是楠竹，那这种伞把的话它是水竹的。
哦、so we can see the whole umbrella is made by bamboo, and what's special is the skeleton here and the handle here are making of different kind of bamboo. Actually, those skeleton have to use those bamboos that are aged are growing more than 3 years in the sunny side of the mountain. And this is the original bamboo here. You can see the hollow of that here. And this is chopped by a huge bamboo. Actually, yesterday we went to a bamboo forest together, and it's not very easy to tell how the age of a bamboo, because the size of the bamboo is determined by the size of the bamboo shoots. You can see lots of very strong and thick bamboo shoots there, and they will in the spring and they will grow into a huge bamboo and very thick bamboo in a month or so. But a three-year bamboo, an old bamboo, a good and very hard bamboo have to be selected by very experienced technique.
Sichuan 的一个三省的一个交汇的地方，原来也是一个茶马的一个古道嘛。因为当时出四川的话，就是我们的西南大门必从我们这里过，因为当时贵州云南呢有很多少数民族，他们的风俗的习惯的话，他会用到一些红色的油纸伞，他不管是什么事儿的话他都会用到。所以说当时我们就会用一些血的元素啊在里面，它会起到一种辟邪的作用。
Those red umbrellas we can see hanging on the roof, they are expect for the hope of good fortune. They also have some of the ancient people also believe those red umbrellas can against the evil. Actually, Luzhou City here in Sichuan province is the joining part of three provinces, and there are also many our ancestors are using those umbrellas to make their good fortune while traveling on the road. 这些不一样的这个图案都是有哪些是你们新创造的？
这些很多都是因为这一伞都是比较时间有点长了，因为看上去不是那么新的。其实这很多图案都是我们之后在创作的，就是我回来以后的。
适合送给什么人呢？
梅花的话，哎呀，梅花就是送给一些朋友啊，长辈都可以送。然后像，主要是看你对象是什么。你像一些梅兰竹菊啊，它都作为我们中国的一个四君子的一个元素，它就是送，基本上都可以通送的。然后像一些像我们之前的传统的龙凤呈祥的话，它可能要送一点。长辈要这样子可能比较好一点，因为他们对这些传统元素比较喜欢。
So here we're entering a making skill of an oil paper umbrella, and here is another mystery little bee. And hi, 毕老师您好。
你好，
he's now making the skeleton of an umbrella, and Mr. B is.
现在 做烤这个橙子。这个橙子是这个山里最主要的、最重要的一个部分。它烤了必须要碾紧，真的把碾好，把它做成三角，然后再糊在那吃。
Mr. Biliofu is the pointed national intangible culture heritage inheritor, and he is also the sixth generation of the Bi family's oil making technique. This looks quite difficult, Bi 老师。
他这个当时也不难，只要做习惯了就不难。他这个必须要一把它碾好，因为
This is the main part of the skeleton of this umbrella, and every piece of the bamboo are handmade.
所以把它碾好以后，在过去是头发来碾，现在由于头发太贵了，用线来碾。它碾两转。可以做。
这个技术要学多少年 ？How many years can capture this technique？
这个说山最主要的是从开头学就在过去就要学三年，包括这个选柱啊、锯柱啊，做这个三角三股，要学三年才学得会。因为现在由于这个，因为全部学会的话要三年才能够时间久了。现在我们基本上是，每一道工序的话。就一个人就学过几道工序就差不多了。
In ancient time, if you want to fully capture the whole process of making an umbrella, you have to study for full 3 years. But now, in the modern factory, not really a modern factory, it's also a handmade.Factory, and that people will just learn a few process for a few process of the procedure, and they can combining a whole umbrella together. And now Mr. B is connecting the two parts of the skeleton, inside part and the outside part.做这一步需要注意的是什么呀？
要注意了，注意就是要不能烤错了，有的每片按程序去，按程序去，它的这个烟要这个要分几位，这个两层烟，有一盘是这个天盘烟，有一层是妖烟，这上面我烤这层就是我讲的是。土一直叫做妖眼
要细心他说这里有两个孔也不能够把这个孔穿到上面个孔去了
对
下面个孔穿到上面个孔去了然后如果是穿错了的话它一样是能够撑开风但是到就会影响到后面的东西
OK So this chopped bamboo skeleton are drilled many holesSome of the holes are using to connect the two parts, and some other holes are using to sew the thread. Bi 老师，您觉得哪一部分是最难的呀？
其实对我来说也没有什么是最难的，只是说工序比较繁，就是说它很考验一个人的持之以恒的要去坚持去做这样它这个应该是最难的因为工序比较多
I was asking which procedure is the hardest for Mr. B, and he told me mostly the hardest part is perseverance, because there are hundreds more making an umbrella, and every procedure you have to be very cautious and very patient to make sure that the every procedure is the right one, and because if you are one step wrong, the rest of steps will be affected.
如果说是正常的做的话，起码最少要几天做那些，就算每一把山的话都是如果说是正常的做的话，像这样的山就要几天来做那些吧。但是如果说是流水作业做的稍微快一点，但我们基本上都是流水作业做的比较多。如果你专门做一把的话，它过程一样的弄多，它始终要去去做啊、看住啊，要做这要干了得行，做到底儿了工序。但是一般情况都是都流水作业做，只要你快一点。 因为我们原来是分开了做的，就说复制的有专门复制，穿线的专门穿线，这样就快一点。如果真正的每一把山都要求一个人可以做完的话，还有很多工人的话，他做不完的，他跟没那个技术的，都要学很久。而且我们做山的人，首先第一个就是要讲究的要有作心，要有作心耐心，很些来学的会。
像有些东西就很多人都做不来，比如说我们打这个出一条开关，很多人都做不来的。那就从选竹子，选竹子到选完竹子就锯下来，就直接做成木条。
啊，选竹子选下来就首先就是砍嘛，砍了以后就要锯节，锯节过要刮青，青过了就要插隔板儿。
把隔板刨平，然后呢，我一直在开花，花了要削，这个繁琐得很，削了，太开槽口，口朝了钻孔，它要太繁琐了，关键是。就是需要等在竹子还是在新鲜的时候，就把它切成条，然后钻孔。
生，因为生的时候它好花了嘛。
So the special thing here is the bamboo stick, the skeleton of the bamboo have to be made right after the bamboo was chopped from the mountain, because only the fresh bamboo can be chopped easily, and the peel of the fresh bamboo are more easy to peel off.
这个伞架现在就基本上做好了。没有，还要学开关了吧？好，我们把这个针穿进去。耳朵掉了嘛？嗯。你是打几个嘛？嗯。你去打几个嘛？嗯。
I want to show you guys a very special thing. Is this part of the this part can support the skeleton here. Yes.
它是没有弹簧的。
So there's no sponge inside it. Just using the shape, special shape of the wood of the bamboo here to support the the bouncing bag. And Mr. B is showing us this special part here.
Give me one. This is
already opened.
把它打开了重新做一遍。
所以就是用那个 竹片塞进去，它就变成这种可以跳动的开关了吗？这是什么时候发明的这种技术？
我的当下我认识我姨姨就是这样做的。
嗯，就从古时候一直是这种做法，
啊，
是吧？
这个是很早以，应该是呢，在千多年前就是这样做的了。
He told me the technique can be traced back in the Qing dynasty. 真的是老祖宗的智慧啊。
嗯，他实际上是用这个利用竹管的韧性，极力反弹，刚刚原理相当于就是。
木头可以做吗？
木头要不得，木头，木头必须要老烂竹，而且这个锤子还要老烂竹要的。
Only an old bamboo can be made because it has enough the.It's soft enough and it's also hard enough to support the umbrella. And other materials such as wood and others cannot be used. Should do this step how long time? Okay. Okay.做这个形状是纯凭感觉吗？有没有什么模子啊？
恢复了吗？
嗯。
看，
全都是靠经验做的吗？
嗯，对。
Making this part of the umbrella requires pure experience because this doesn't have a model or anything. Only different tools and a very experienced hand.
Oh, this要打一步出来，要按键要弹跳自如。它利用竹管的韧性极力反弹，它这个省不了修的，因为我们的伞没有金属，就是这个可以管这个几十年上百年都烂不到的。
嗯，
因为这个竹子是干了的，这个老烂竹头来做的，它的韧性好。
嗯，
这个弹力强，你看吧。
有没有测试过这可以弹多少次？
做几千次可以弹，
嗯，
三千次不变形。我们就讲的是，除了开关之外，
我们讲的是我们的伞是浸泡24小时，伞面它是不会掉，然后顶五级风行走，那个伞它也不会坏。
嗯，
然后这个开关要反复撑开
三千次，
也不会坏，这是我们的一个检验标准。
OK。This part can be opened and closed for 3,000 times without broken. 然后呢，我们看点什么？
一些油纸伞，给你们介绍一下。工具的。
Hi, welcome back. And earlier we have seen how to making the skeleton, and here in another room of the in the craftsmanship, and here we can see Mr. B is framing the skeleton that he's already made just now.
这个都是卡住这个距离的尺子是吗？哦，就是到了到，因为我们的尺子是规定的，一张是大大几条，它必须要宽这一样的。可以展示一下这个尺子吗？
This is actually a ruler made of bamboo to make sure that every skeleton are the same place or same length.
它每个要均匀。嗯，哪个都要均匀。这要缠得很紧吗？哦。那更大一点的伞是要用更大一点的尺子吗？还是？都要。哦。
Different size of the umbrella has different size of the ruler.
要缠几层这个线呢？缠五，最少足够了缠五层。
To make sure that the umbrella is strong enough, the thread here has to be 5 layers.
感觉每一步好像都还挺难做的，对吧？这个要还不线呢，要讲究均匀了。哦。有什么需要注意的吗？这个最主要的每一个的这个宽这线，宽宽的基本上要均匀，才好看。
这一步就有一点伞的形状出来了。This procedure, you can see the, you can see the shape of the umbrella. 这个线它的强度有多大？会不会断呢？断不到。这个线呢，它是一个线是很可以往很多个伞的。
棉线必须要棉线。
棉线就可以。
棉线它那种粘得起了嘛，其他线要不得的。要粗一点的棉线。不细的都可以。
哦，细的也可以。那怎么保证棉线不会断？棉线最主要的是，这个江湖的这个地方的话的，能扒来起，如果轻点的线的话就死就不容易粘紧。
哦，
就都是经验。 These threads are cotton thread because the cotton thread are more easy to connecting the special glue that is applied while applying the paper on the umbrella. 感觉这个伞好环保，做的所有的东西，它所有用的材料都是可降解的。啥子复式了？复式了？复式了噻。
哦，糊纸。
The next step is applying paper on it. 咱们是用什么胶水在粘呢？胶水。嗯，什么胶啊？
浆糊是用米做的吗？浆糊是那个灰面做的，灰豆浆。哦。广豆浆做的。豆浆就早上磨的豆浆。嗯。原生态都是。哇，豆浆和什么东西做的？都是豆浆。这是现场展示的，就不是用的。我们真正的做用豆浆的。
The original way to make the glue is using soy juice. This place is a demonstration place, so Mr. B is using water instead of the glue here to show us how to apply the paper on it. All of the materials are daily, very common in our day-to-day life, and they can be made into exquisite umbrellas. Quite amazing. This 贴纸的时候要注意些什么？这个要杯口要均匀，做勾勾伸起来要均匀。
是分成了四张纸在贴上去吗？哦，有的是八张，有的是十张，有的是七张，那根据山的大小，不一样。这个纸有什么特别的地方？纸啊，纸是要皮质，必须要有皮质料的，皮质或者棉质，但是我们用的都是皮质比较多。皮质是怎么做的？皮质就是勾树皮来做的。
哦。树皮做的。 This paper is made of the skin of the gold tree. It's harder than a normal paper, but it's still paper. 这伞如果坏了的话，要怎么补啊？坏了就是要用很薄的纸来补。哦。就好补吗？好补，你习惯了就。 Because of the oil paper umbrella is made of paper, so it's also very easy to remend it if it's broken. Just use thin paper to apply on the hole. So one umbrella can be used for many years.
用不了多长时间。哦。一般可以用多长时间？多长时间？一把伞。嗯。一把伞正常的用的话就，会用几年噻。嗯。正常的用可以用几年？因为古时候的话，基本上就是讲的是这个修修补补的用三年嘛。哦。
An umbrella, an oil paper umbrella, if are using in day-to-day life, after remending a few times, it can be used for 3 to 5 years also. 其实也挺耐用的了。Actually, the oil paper umbrella also has its ups and downs. And earlier, Mr. B told me that in the beginning of the 21st century, there are not so many people who stick to this craftsmanship in Luzhou City. Actually, in Fenshuiling County, at one time, there are only Mr. B and his wife are continue to make an umbrella in the most traditional way. It's because of the more lighter and more convenient folding umbrella came into the market, and the oiled paper umbrella are fading away. But after until 2008, after the oiled paper umbrella, craftsmanship has been nominated and appointed as a national intangible cultural heritage. It has regained its popularity among people, especially some young people. They are very interested in the national traditional Chinese trend. This part, I think, is whether it determines the umbrella is beautiful or not.
对。This
is a very important procedure because it depends the the appearance of the umbrella. And after the umbrella was making oil paper umbrella scale was appointed as national intangible cultural heritage, and Mr. Bi Liufu here was the interior of the inheritor of the national intangible cultural heritage. And his son just spoke to us. Mr. Bi Yuansheng, he came back from Chengdu City, one of the major city in China, and he came back to inherit this handmade skill. Although he can make the he knows the skill since he's a small child. When he came back and decided to recapture it, he has to learn it step by step. And actually, nowadays you can find you can buy those oil paper umbrellas online. It's quite popular. The next step is waiting for the to dry up, waiting for it to dry up, and then to apply oil on it. After the paper is dried, they will apply a special tone oil on the surface of the umbrella. Actually, yesterday I experienced a little bit of applying the tone oil on it. The tone oil has a very special scent. It's a special oil that is extracted from the fruit of the tone tree. And it has a special smell. I cannot tell it's good or not very good, but I quite like it. And the oil itself is it's very easy to dry, and after the oil is applied on the surface of the umbrella, the paper can be waterproof and is strong enough to against a very strong wind. The most highest level of the wind can raise to a force 5 wind. So it's quite useful in daily life. Because we're demonstrating the procedure, we're not using actual glues made of soy sauce, so soy juice. So pure water is just not very easy to make it very even.
Yes. 行了吗？
可以了。 那这个就是拿到旁边去晾干吗？
就你今天的这个，什么要不得的，这个完没完，还需要了还缺腿了，
嗯，
还有很多工序完成的，这组织不给也是缺这个食品，
嗯，
行了吗？
嗯 ，OK。Now we've seen the, the main procedure of making an umbrella. Actually, it's half a way to making an actual umbrella here, especially an oil paper umbrella. And after the visiting to Luzhou City and Fenshuilin County, and after visiting this special oil paper umbrella, and I'm really impressed that the ancient wisdom can still shelter the shelter us and kept us from the rainy day and the sunny day. And I'm also really pleased to see that those ancient craftsmanship can be passed down by a family like B. They are, they told me that they are using the e-commerce to boost the sellings. And they also have their own company and own brand as Biliofu, and called the brand is called Biliofu, is the name after the inheritor of the intangible cultural heritage. And actually, their selling online is quite good, and especially after the national Chinese, traditional Chinese trend are a goal rival in young people's, the selling of the umbrella are boosting, and more people are enjoying and are interested in the making procedure of the oil paper umbrella. And they are by more curious about the umbrella, and they can know more about their own culture. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. Bye bye.